Hi, I have a question regarding a case. So it's a 9-year-old child, and as I observed, there are some substitution errors and also some distortions. So, for example, for t, she substitutes it as the all the time, and for the, she substitutes it as the all the time, and even r. She tells sometimes like l and sometimes it's distorted. And also s and sh sounds. Can I please know how to proceed in this case? Can you please help me regarding this?
Okay. Could you please highlight on how about our oromotor skills? Have you assessed?
Yeah, the yes. When I assessed it, like all the articulators are functionally and structurally normal, and when I was like assessing the function of the tongue, then when I told her to touch it up at the palate and hold it, the jaw was kind of moving and she was not able to take it up so perfectly. So that was one thing which I observed. Rather than that, everything is fine, even the pressure building up, everything.
Okay, so what I understand from whatever overview that you have given is there is a need of thorough oromotor assessment once again. If she's able to hold for how many seconds she's able to hold, you should be very clear with that. If there is some jaw discoordination present, you can go back to our video on oromotor skills and find out about those things and work on it in detail. All right, and according to the
Yes.
speech sound error that you have been telling me, it seems more like a fronting error. She's substituting r with l, so that means it's a gliding error.
Yes.
Correct? So, apart
Yes.
from these, there are sh errors are there. So, yes, so fricatives are also a problem. So, from what you are telling me, these fronting errors, so I will kind of divide my therapy plan into specific domains. So, first would be oromotor skills. So, as I said, first you assess and you plan specifically that maybe you are
Yes.
targeting the tongue jaw discoordination, maybe you are targeting the elevation of tongue. So be that specific in your goal. Okay, so that will be one part of your domain which you will work on for like in every session, you will keep on going further and further for some time. Okay, according to the severity
Okay.
of whatever is affected, you need to plan it like that. Okay, now we have come to my goal is going to be for improving the articulatory skills. So in that articulation
Yes.
skills, I will divide my goals. I know my 3 to 4 affected. So I will keep my goal as to be child will be able to produce t sound or the child will be able to produce d sound. Okay, you will keep this as your goal. You will always
Okay.
mention the accuracy and consistency. That at what level, how much accurate do you want and how much consistency you want the child to produce it. So this has to be there in
Okay.
your goal. This is your long-term goal. Now, if that long-term goal, you can always categorize it. So, first of all, the child should be having a awareness of his or her problem. So, you will check for
Yes.
if he is not aware. If she's not aware of her problem, she has to be made aware. So, you are going to do discrimination tasks, internal, external discrimination. You will do internal,
Okay.
external. All this discrimination, child must know. Now, you know the child is already aware about the problem. Now you're going to start with the production. Now production has to be in a hierarchy. First, you are supposed to target on isolation. At isolation level, child should be able to produce that sound. Then comes the syllable level. Then comes the word level. At word
Okay.
level, it has to be initial, middle, final, all the levels, and lot of drilling has to be done. After a lot of
Yes.
drilling is done and child is perfect in those, at least 90% accuracy. So 9 out of 10 target words are produced correctly, then only you move on to the next. And you decide the level. It's nothing specific. You decide the level that how much do you want the child to go. And then you can move on
Okay.
to the sentence level. And maybe after that you can expect that a conversation. Okay, so before that, this hierarchy, you are supposed to follow this hierarchy, and this happens for each. Now, it depends on case to case. So your child, you are saying, is 9 year old. So I'm assuming that
Yeah.
she has no cognitive issues, also, you said. So she is
Yes.
able to grasp well, so I can work on simultaneous sound at the same time also. But you think that she's
Yes.
getting confused, then I might work on one sound and after one sound is achieved up to 90%, only then I go to the next sound. It's all according to you and your client. It's not specific to anything. So maybe one sound I'm working for 90% accuracy, but the child has achieved like 60-70%. I can move to the next sound and I can target it for up to only 50% accuracy. That all depends on anything that you use. Okay, so your
overall
sound case are one, your production of your target sound is one part. Now also selection of what sound you will be doing, that is also supposed to be, if there is no concrete answer for that, usually it's according to the acquisition level. So if it would be a younger child, I would go Turda first rather than Sersha, and she would be targeted last. But she is 9 years old, whatever she already knows, you can start from that, and it all depends upon what she is able to grasp faster. So from that, the motivation will also be maintained, right? And yeah, so this is how ideally a case will be worked upon, specifically your case that you mentioned. This is how it would, I would work upon it, okay? Now, could you tell them what you have been doing so that we can help you more on what else you can do?
As I told that when I came to know about this, I just didn't want it to just sit and waste time. As I called the child, and the first thing was I gave the demonstration, and I told the child, like, the child is very clever and she's smart enough, and she's pretty conscious about her problem, and also she's aware that she's concerned and she wants to get rid of it as soon as possible. And also when I explained her, she was able to grasp it and understand it. Also, there's one more thing that I wanted to mention. She's very good in her academics, where she stands top 3 in her class, and also very confident in the academics. But when it comes to some speech talk or public talk or mock talk, something like that, the kid is like, she's facing some lack of confidence, and she is just resisting herself not to go there and tell. Okay, she doesn't want to speak up now. She has become a little kind of gumsum, and also some things like twitching her eyes, and when things come, when the target sound comes, where she knows that there's a problem and she's telling it wrong, she does things like this. And also she just moves here, there. She doesn't want to look at us or the listener. This thing.
Behaviors are present, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, you have you ruled out fluency issues?
Yes, yes. Okay. There's no fluency issues.
Okay, fine. I'll just ask you, so what have you targeted first? What did you target and what did you start with?
First thing was I gave the proper demonstration, and I told her, like, for the target sound T and T, I told her, say, the tongue placement will be here. I myself demonstrated it. And also using the ice cream stick and all, I have shown the position to the child. Okay, here it should be placed. This thing was which I followed.
Okay.
And then I went to, like, as I had no such idea, but then I just skipped on to the words, like the letter, the sentence was like Tokyo, Tony took Tommy to Tokyo. This kind of sentences where T is more.
Okay.
So these things I took it.
Okay. So you said multiple things, and I'll just address one by one, which I felt that there were glitches. Okay. So firstly, you said you demonstrated. Okay, you demonstrating it is a different thing, and she is understanding that the difference between them. That means she is able to discriminate, which is great. Now you have to come to her production. So you have not waited for her to produce it differently, like both the sounds differently, and you directly started with producing of sentence level. Okay, so that
the
hierarchy you have gone wrong. Even an awareness level, actually, we break it down. That child is aware at phonemic level, child is aware at syllable level. So first I will say ta, ta. So if child can discriminate, then I'll say tasveer, tomato. So if on word level, she can discriminate or no. So you have missed the steps in between. So even while you are demonstrating, after you demonstrated, you are saying that she has understood that where she is going wrong. She has able to discriminate on all these levels. She should be able to discriminate. Only possible. Then only you come to her production. Let her say from isolation level to the sentence level. Follow that hierarchy. So that is, I think, where you are missed out. So you are supposed to work on that. Okay.
Okay.
Now you mentioned about psychological issues. I would term these as psychological issues because of her age, and she's understanding her cognition is
yes.
Right? So
yes.
I think reference to a psychologist would be required in this case. Or even if you are able to do a good job, then even you can continue. It depends on how much severe it's affecting her, right? So,
and also, I wanted to tell you something, like she is also facing some kind of bullying in the school,
right?
Just because her speech is not clear. She has very less friends. These things are going on, which is in turn causing her like not to go back or not to speak with them. And she's feeling isolated.
Correct. So all these things, that is why I said looking at the patient holistically is very important. So that is where perfectly you mentioned that we should be requiring a psychologist on board to treat or to discuss these issues with. Or in some cases where psychologist is not readily available, it's you who are supposed to do a very good job in counseling. But ideally, a psychologist would be preferable, right? So I hope that clears your query, and as you rightly said, the psychological point of view is also cleared. Okay, I'll just ask you one question. Like you said, first you demonstrated and then how you went to the production level. What did you check for, any specific keywords?
As in?
Like did you check that if that particular word, like suppose like for example, you're saying that she's not able to use R. So was it there that R was present in some words? You said it's distorted, right? So in which context
yes.
was it not distorted? When was the time that it was not distorted?
Okay. The only sound which was distorted was R. When it comes to the initial word, like initial thing when R exists, like for example, rat or roti, something like that. She tells it like loti or lat, something like this.
Is not distortion, my dear. That is substitution.
No. Yeah. This at initial level she does it like substitution.
Okay.
But when it comes to the final thing, for example, like a car or something like that, she tells a car, something like this.
Okay.
The last word is totally, the last sound is ra, is totally distorted. And which will make the whole word like not meaningful. This was the thing.
Right. So why did I ask you this specifically? It will be a little tip to help you in your intervention. That if some words are present, so some cases she is able to produce. That means she knows how to produce it, but she is not able to generalize it maybe, or in some contexts or in some positions she is able to do it, but in some she is not able to do. So if you have keywords, you can also use paired stimuli approach. You should go
yes.
back and read about it. And you will get it in any of the articulation therapy books. Bernthal and
yes.
Benson will be a very good book. It has it in very detail. So,
sorry, can you please repeat it? I couldn't hear it.
Bernthal and Benson.
Okay, thank you.
That book, and you can just check this approach. You can find it on internet also. How is it done? Because you're saying that she has keywords and she's already aware about it. You can probably use that approach. You can try that approach for your few sounds. Correct?
Yes.
So anything else that you like? You'd like us to answer for you, or did you get some clarity regarding it? How you are going to proceed?
Yes, it helped a lot. I just want you to like tell me some activity for this, like one or two activities which I can later plan it, like I can go through some things.
Okay.
Initially I just want to start up.
Okay. So you have so many goals. For all the goals you will have specific set of activities. So for if the oromotor
yes.
Is your goal, then the activities are going to be whatever your elevation and all that, whatever your oromotor skills that you will be doing, blowing,
yes,
everything. So all those activities come there. Okay. Now
yes.
for the production part, now you need to keep in mind that she is 9 years old. Okay. So you cannot just
yes.
Use any activity and you just say the word and give a reinforcement. That's not very interesting, right? So you can use some
yes.
Mature activities with her. So if first drilling has to be done. There is no substitution to drilling. Okay, but
okay.
those drillings are done. Then maybe if you're working at a word level, so to produce a target word, what would you do? So you may play a tag or guess who game where you're describing
yes,
the
yes.
entire thing, entire picture, and then you are telling, you are making her think and answer the target word. So she comes up with a target word. Okay, so this is something adult would like to do, right? Then saying the same word along in a group, you can take also group therapies are also very beneficial for this age group. So it can happen. Yeah. It will generalize to a normal conversation level faster if group therapies are done, right? So you can take some group, and you can actually use one thing that works very beautifully with older children is feedback.
Hmm.
Always record her own utterances, and you can ask her, you can play it back to her, and then she can listen to it and she can self-correct. Self-monitoring is something that they already understand, they can understand at that level, and they would like to do that. So they'll have a model in front of them, which is you, or their own utterance when they are saying it correctly, that can be their model, and then this feedback can help him, help them to self-correct, and thus it will lead to a correct production of sound, right?
Okay, I'll surely do this.
Please try that and please get back to us on how is with it, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much for having us. And
thanks a lot. Seriously, this is very good approach, and it's like one-on-one, and it helps a lot rather than reading books. It's okay, we should have the bookish knowledge.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, we should know the theory, but as you explained, if somebody explains it the way you are doing, then it will be a very helpful thing for the young coming professionals like us. So I'm very glad that you came up and helped me.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.